And the much anticipated meeting between Pope Francis and President Donald Trump finally took place Wednesday at the Vatican. In spite of their well-aired differences, the two leaders enjoyed a cordial meeting. Much was made of one of the Pope's gifts to the president, a copy of his environmental encyclical, Laudato Si. However, Trump actually received all three of the Pope's major writings. The Vatican communique suggested that the two leaders discussed life, the environment, peace in the Middle East, and religious freedom. During Trump's meeting later with Vatican Secretary of State Cardinal Pietro Parolin, he urged Trump not to withdraw from the 2015 Paris Agreement on climate change. Trump has indicated that he has yet to make a decision about the matter. In the aftermath of the visit, the president took to Twitter, saying, "I leave the Vatican more determined than ever to pursue peace in our world." He also switched out his profile pic on Twitter to one of he smiling across the desk from the Holy Father. And earlier in the week, while in the Middle East, President Trump paid a visit to the Church of the Holy Sepulchre, the site of Christ's crucifixion and his resurrection. Among those who received him was the president of the Franciscan Foundation for the Holy Land, Father Peter Vasko. He joins us now via phone from the Holy Land. Father Peter, thanks for joining us.
Raymond, it's a pleasure always talking with you.
Now tell me, Father Peter, what was the president's reaction when he first met you? And I know you entered and took him to the edicule, the actual tomb of Jesus.
Well, when he first came down, like most of the other presidents, into the courtyard, he was greeted by the Greek patriarch, the Armenian patriarch, and the custos. Mm-hmm. And then, according to the White House advance team, when he came closer, I was asked to go to meet him and to make the introduction to the various superiors. Mm-hmm. The three superiors of the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. Mm-hmm. And I went right up to him and I shook his hand. I said, "Mr. President, I'm Father Peter Vasko. I'm from Brooklyn, New York." He turned to his wife, Melania, and said, "Did you hear that great accent? I like this guy." So it began off with just a wonderful beginning. And I welcomed him to the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. Mm-hmm. And it was an honor for me to be there with him. And we entered into the Holy Sepulchre. We then went to the anointing stone, which is adjacent down further from Calvary.
Right.
And said a little quiet prayer, and then we went up to Calvary, and both President Trump and his wife Melania were very touched. I mean, he came both as a world leader, but he also came as a pilgrim. Hmm. And when we got up to the crucifixion scene, they knelt and they were praying for about five minutes, just reflecting. And it was a lot of silence, but there was a lot going on, which is their personal prayer life, and it was very, very inspiring. I then took him to the two Catholic altars, the Mother of Sorrows and the place of the crucifixion, explaining the details of each altar.
You gave him a gift as well, didn't you?
Well, that was later on, towards the end, when he visited the tomb of our Lord. Mm. You remember about 8 months ago, the tomb was under construction, and we did open the slab, which, of course, underneath was where the body of our Lord was. Mm-hmm. And we had taken a piece of the rock, a small, chipped off a piece of a rock from that, mm-hmm. and we put the slab back on. And what I did was to give him a very small stone placed in a box from the tomb itself of Christ, where he was. It's a priceless piece. It's not a gift. It's a momentum. And he was there kneeling at the place where our Lord resurrected, and to get a piece of that stone from the tomb of our Lord, I know it was very special for him. He just looked at me and said, "Thank you so very much." Mm. And it was very, very powerful from that point. I know I had a chance to speak to Mr. Kushner, the son-in-law mm-hmm. of President Trump, and Ivana. And when I mentioned we had that small little momentum, he says, "Oh, Father Peter," he says, you have to give this to the president. This is something so very special. He would really love it. And he did. He just took it so graciously, et cetera.
And tell me, before I let you go, how important was this visit, in your opinion, Father Peter Vasko, to the people in the region, particularly since the president spoke out so strongly against terrorism and for religious freedom and tolerance?
Oh, I think it was a very important visit, and what he said, people on both sides were very impressed by what he was saying, and they saw that he really had an agenda of peace and trying to bring reconciliation between the conflicting parties. There was a good number of people and jubilation that you have from time to time. I mean, to see the President of the United States going back and forth as in walking, he waved to a good number of people. It was a happy occasion. But from a spiritual standpoint, it was he fulfilled his position as a pilgrim coming to see the two holiest sites of Christianity, and he was so respectful and so prayerful, both President Trump and Mrs. Trump.
Yeah.
It was a wonderful experience.
Excellent.
It was only about 25 minutes, but that's all he had. But it was so important and so special.
Well, Father Peter Vasko, thank you for giving us that special insight and for all you do. We'll have much more on Trump's first foreign trip, his push for peace, the Manchester attack, and the fight against Islamic extremism later in the program. And what might be surprising news coming out of the president's first trip abroad is the First Lady of the United States, Melania Trump, admitting that she is Catholic. The White House confirmed the speculation that Melania Trump is indeed a practicing Catholic after she was seen during her visit to Rome's Children's Hospital crossing herself and praying openly before a statue of the Virgin Mary. During her audience with Pope Francis, she also asked the Pope to bless her rosary. The Daily Mail broke the news on Wednesday, but it is not known if she's a cradle Catholic or when she might have become Catholic. The president is a lifelong Presbyterian, and the couple were married in an Episcopalian church in Florida.